Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Q. And in this video, we're going to talk about whether or not you need to add surrogate keys to your data warehouse or not. Stay tuned to find out. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, surrogate keys, do you really need them? A member actually sent us a question and said, hey, I understand why I would need surrogate keys for dimensions that have type 2 attributes, but what if they don't? Why do I really need surrogate keys? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you. So you all know how I like to do, instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So imagine you have a source system that looks like this, and you have a customer table. And in the customer table, this is your primary key or your natural key, and it's an integer. And so this is what your CRM system looks like. And then over here, when you design your data warehouse, you use that customer ID as the primary key, and there are currently 100,000 customers in there. And you're using this customer ID as the primary key in your dimension, but it's also the natural key in your source, okay? And then there's a merger in your company and you purchase a new CRM, or you merge with a new company and you need to bring their customers in. But wait, before you even think about anything, you need to remember your fact table also, because that table is also using that natural key, that primary key from your source system, and there's a constraint built on that table to ensure you're inserting, you know, only those dimensions. What do you do if something like that happens? They change the source system, they add new customers to the source system, but there's a big difference for those customers. Let me show you. If you go back, and let's say you merge with another company and they have another CRM system and your customer IDs are integers, but their customers are strings, and it's a format, something that looks like this. How do you bring that to your data warehouse when both the dimension and the fact are facts, are using integers, and they're using that original natural key, but now it's a string? What do you do? Well, you can go make some changes. You know, I was talking to Adam about this and he's like, let's just union the two tables together and do a cast and do the same thing in the data warehouse, make another dimension. You could do that, but now there's more managed, there's more things for you to maintain. But if you would use a surrogate key, you wouldn't go through this. So let's say instead of building your dimension to look like this, to use your natural key, your primary key from your source, and also the same key in your fact table. Let's say you created your dimension and you created a surrogate key. So the surrogate key, it's really an anonymous value. It doesn't have any meaning. The only meaning is for you and your data warehouse. And it's typically auto-generated. And it's the primary key for each row that comes into that dimension. And then your natural key, or the primary key from your source, if you want to keep it in your data warehouse, you can make it really flexible by making that a string and just start inserting values into it. So if it changes, if you merge with a new company that's doing something different, you just can continue to add values there. And so that will handle the dimension side of it. And then on your fact side, when you build your fact table, you would not use that natural key in the fact table at all. You would use the surrogate key, create the constraint on the surrogate key. And now what you do is insulate yourself from those types of changes. If you merge with a new company, if the source system changes what the natural key or the primary key is, you can keep it, you can track it if you want to, but you don't have to worry about it affecting how you load your data warehouse, because you've insulated yourself from it by abstracting yourself from that primary key using the surrogate key. All right, what do you guys think? Any questions, any comments? Are you using surrogate keys? You don't want to use surrogate keys? It's completely up to you, but I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.